Well, I've seen a couple of people on YouTube mention the website RadioShackCatalogs.com, and it is a great website, but I think this is even better. It's a collection of Radio Shack catalogs from 1981 to 1999. Now, I don't have all of them. I'm missing a few. I'm missing 1988 and also 96, 97, and 98. It jumps from 95 to 99. A few of the newer ones are from my own collection from visiting stores when I was a kid. But most of these older ones came as part of a collection. When I was back in high school, a couple from Connecticut donated to me a Tandy 2000 computer and also a Radio Shack TRS-80 Model 1 computer. Two complete systems with all the software and documentation and everything, which I have since donated both of those collections and computers to another collector. But I kept the catalogs, which came along with it. So, going back to 1981 was when they bought their TRS-80 Model 1, and they pretty much kept up with all the catalogs, and I think up to 92. So that's from their collection mostly. So it's a great resource to have, you know, if you find a Radio Shack product and you want to know more about it, or when it was sold and when it was new. Just look through the catalogs and you can find pretty much every year of the catalogs on that website. But I like these better because they're a lot faster to navigate and you get the original quality, not a pixelated scan of it. So there you have it. Radio Shack catalogs from 1981 to 1999. I think the last one they ever made catalog was in 2002. So in addition to those two gaps, there's a couple newer ones beyond 99 that I would need to complete the collection, at least back to 81. Here you have State of Art Fashion from 1981. Quite a throwback. And they had some really nice receivers back then. You can get a complete system like that. This was a nice one. One of the early ones of digital tuning. Let me see, what's the power on this one? 60 watts per channel. And they had their slimline ones. This is the big heavyweight one. 120 watts per channel, $700, brand new. All the way down to these little budget model tuners. Hi-fi TV sound, that was before they had stereo TV, so just a hi-fi mono TV sound. And a couple phonographs. Nice one there. Speakers. Tape decks. They had some really nice ones, like frequency response from 30 hertz to 21,000 hertz. That's almost as good as a CD player. In fact, this is better than a CD. This is reel-to-reel, 30 hertz to 28,000 hertz. A CD cuts off at 22,000. Recording 8 tracks, portable 8 track, boom boxes. Here's the legendary Mini Set 9, brand new for 81, $80. Realistic pre-recorded stereo cassettes and 8-tracks. Here's your reel-to-reel tape, all your accessories, 8-track head cleaner, those big headphones, all-in-one systems, some pretty nice ones actually. Magnetic cartridge, you don't see that too often in these built-in all-in-one systems. And then the cheapy ones for the kids. A deal for any kid's room. And even this little thing, $24.95. The jeans look. That's a nice one. Record accessories. All your cartridges, styli, cables. Build your own speaker system. They don't sell these individual components like this anymore. Try to look on the shelf these days and they hardly have anything. Microphones, PA equipment, some nice vintage ones here. 12 volts DC or AC. Mixers, power horns, intercoms. Here's your car stereo tape decks. I didn't see the one that RetroChad just showed a model. I think it was a 12-18-12. I didn't see it in any of my catalogs, so it must be from before 1981. Look at that van. Mobile stereo receiver. Car radios. A special model for GM X-body cars where you can make it vertical. Car speakers, scanners, power supplies, radar detectors, some of the really old ones there. And so on and so forth, the whole nine yards here. Really vintage answering machines. Rotary phone there. TV antennas. CB radios. All your various components. See if we can find the page where they show tubes. Might have passed it already. I think they might have. There it is. Radio Shack Lifetime Tubes. I wonder if they still honor that guarantee. Batteries. Testers. Toys. Little portable radios here, flavor radios, portable TV, clock radios, table radios, including an AM only version, shortwave radios, that one actually has long wave too, calculators. And there's your TRS-80 Model 1 computer. I think this was the last year they sold it because it didn't meet the FCC standards for radio interference, so they had to take it off the market. There's a Model 3, Model 2 business computer with 8-inch disk drives, size of a toaster oven there. Daisy wheel printers. Color computer and the pocket computer, which actually programs in BASIC. My dad had one of these and I used it for a couple years in school. It's pretty neat. So that's the 81 catalog, just a quick glance through.